Dear friends, this is Srinivasan, who is having more than 40 years experience in the construction industry, trying to present you a small presentation, the difference between the stone and ashlar masonry. It's a civil conclave presentation. Stone masonry, rock that is removed from its natural size and generally cut or dressed and then finished for a building purposes is called stone, and the art of building the structure with the stones as a constructional unit is called as stone masonry. This is the image of the stone masonry building. Main types of stone masonry: rubble masonry, ashlar masonry. Rubble masonry, the stone masonry in which either undressed or roughly dressed stones are laid is called as rubble masonry. In this masonry, the joints of mortar are not uniform thickness. Types of rubble masonry: random rubble masonry. In the random rubble masonry, you can have two categories. One is known as uncoarse random rubble masonry. Another one is built to coarse random rubble masonry. Then another category is squared rubble. In this we had unsquared rubble masonry, built to courses squared rubble masonry, and a regular course squared rubble masonry. And then the third category is a dry masonry. Random rubble masonry. This is the image of a random rubble masonry. The rubble masonry in which either undressed or hammer dressed stones are used is called random rubble masonry. The strength of this masonry depend upon the bond between the stones. The bond should be sound both transversely and longitudinally. Transverse bond is obtained by the liberal use of the bonders and thorough. Bonders are stone which reach beyond the middle of the wall from each face to overlap the center, dog's teeth bond. Thoroughs are stones which extend the full thickness of the wall. Note, thoroughs should not be used in the external walls as moisture may be conducted through them and cause dampness on the internal walls. See, this is what I called as a bond stone. In this image, you will learn about the entire stone masonry. This is the top stone, coping cum copper. This is a bafer, what we call this. This is the face stones. Cover band covers are a clocks. This is known as a hearting. This is known as a thorough stone. Okay? Previously, we see the bond stone. This is the thorough stones, foundation of the footings. So you will get a rough idea how the random rubble masonry has been carried out. Uncoarse random rubble masonry. These are the images of the uncoarse rubble masonry, which you can see at elevation, DPC, and then here you can see bonder. In the top, it will be a thorough, okay? The random rubble masonry in which all the stones are laid without forming courses is known as uncoarse random rubble masonry. The masonry is the cheapest and roughest type of a masonry. The stones to be used in this masonry are of different sizes and shapes. Longer stones used at corners and at jams to increase the strength. In general, stones are laid with the longer axis, roughly horizontal and along with the length of the wall. The only shaping of the stone that is executed is the removal of inconvenient corner or projections with the hammer. This type of masonry is used for constructing walls of low height in case of buildings. Built to courses random rubble masonry. This is the image of the built to courses random rubble masonry. In this type of masonry, the work is roughly leveled up to form courses varying from 12 to 18 inches in thick. In each course, headers of one course height are placed at certain intervals. This type of masonry is used to construct residential buildings, godowns, boundary walls, etc. Squared rubble masonry. This is the image of the squared rubble masonry. This rubble masonry in which the face stones are roughly squared by hammer, dressing or chisel dressing before their actual laying is called squared rubble masonry. There are three types of squared rubble masonry. Uncoarse squared rubble masonry. In this type, squared rubble masonry, the stones are roughly squared and built with continuous horizontal courses. It is used for ordinary buildings in hilly areas where good varieties of stones are easily and cheaply built courses. Squared rubble masonry. This is the image which shows the built square random rubble masonry. The stones are roughly squared and laid in courses in bond in with the larger quoin. Regular course squared rubble masonry. This type of masonry is built in courses of varying height, but the stones in any one course are of the same depth. It is mostly used in public buildings, hospitals, schools, markets, modern residential buildings, where a good quality of stone easily and cheaply. Regular course square rubble masonry. This is the images of the regular square masonry, wherein you can see where the thorough and the bonder has been fixed nicely. This is the elevation and this is the section. This type of masonry is built in courses of varying height, but the stones in any one course are of the same depth, which you can see it here, or same depth. Okay, this is the thorough, this is the bonder. This is the elevational map and this is the sectional map. It is mostly used in public buildings, hospital, schools, markets, modern residential building in the hilly areas, where a good quality of the stone is easily available. Dry rubble masonry. This is the image of the dry rubble masonry. This rubble masonry in which stones are laid without using any mortar is known as a dry rubble masonry. It is an ordinary masonry and is recommended for constructing walls of height not more than 18 feet. In case the height is more, three adjacent cores are laid in square rubble masonry in mortar at 9 feet interval. Types of Aslar masonry. This is the image of the Aslar masonry. The stone masonry in which finely dressed stones are laid in cement or lime mortar is known as Aslar masonry. In this masonry, all the joints are regular, thin and in uniform thickness, which you can see in the images. This type of masonry is costly in construction as involves heavy cost of dressing the stones. This masonry is used for heavy structure, arches, architectural buildings, high piers, abutments of bridges, etc. Aslar fine coarse rubble masonry. In this type of masonry, stone blocks of same heights are used in each course. Every stone is fine tooled in all sides. Thickness of the mortar joint less than 1/16 inches and is uniform through. Random coarse Aslar masonry. This is the image of the random coarse Aslar masonry. This type of Aslar masonry consists of fine or coarse Aslar masonry, but the courses are varying thicknesses depending upon the character of the building. rough tooled ashlar masonry. In this type of ashlar masonry, the sides of the stones are rough tooled and dressed with chisels. Thickness of joints does not exceed 1/4 inch. Quarry faced ashlar masonry. See, this is the image of the quarry faced ashlar masonry. It is similar to quarry face, except that the edges are given a slope of 45 degrees for a depth of 1 meter or more. Chamfered ashlar masonry. It is similar to quarry face, except that the edges are given a slope of 45 degrees for a depth of 1 inches or more. See here this image, you can understand how this chamfers has been provided. Okay, ashlar facing. In order to reduce the cost and give it to the appearance of ashlar facing to the wall, it is usual practice to construct walls with facing of ashlar and backing of rubble or brick masonry. Such walls also called compound or composite masonry walls. This is what I mean, that this image shows the compound ashlar masonry. In the backing of rubble masonry,
comparison
it is called rubble ashlar
masonry and stone masonry.
And if the backing is a brickwork, the masonry
stone
is termed as a brick
and
ashlar.
More durable than brick, and for public buildings, it is decidedly more suitable than brick. It reflects strength in each inch of it. It is in tune with the nature. Its color improves and looks more serene with the age. Brick offers greater facilities for ornamental work in plaster, as a rough shape can first be given by means of any tool. This is not so in any case of stones. Plaster does not stick so well to stones as it does to the bricks. On the other hand, brick is an artificial product made as a copy of stone. It is flimsy material and plastering is only camouflage for its defects. On account of regular shape and uniform size of the bricks, a proper can be obtained with comparative case. Stone is a waterproof. On the other hand, bricks absorb moisture, and with the dampness, certain salts rise in the walls from the ground and cause disintegration of the bricks. Due to the handy size of the bricks, brick masonry can be more rapidly constructed than the stone masonry. Especially, bricks should not be allowed to come in contact with the urine or sewerage, and in such places, it must always be covered with a cement plaster or any other protective coat. Brick wall requires a fixed quantity of a mortar, and even with the careless masons, the regular shape of the bricks considerably reduces the possibility of hollows being left in the body of the wall. This is not same with the stone. It is possible to brick a walls of any thickness, example 4.5 inches, 3 inches, 9 inches, 13.5 inches, etc. Whereas the minimum thickness of the ordinary stone wall is 15 inches. Stone walls of a similar thickness than 15 inches have to be constructed with the properly dressed stones, which involves comparatively high cost. Brick does not absorb as much heat as stone does, so brick is more fire resistant than. Thank you for watching this presentation. Kindly subscribe, like and share, which will motivate me for a further good presentation. In case of any queries, do not hesitate to write to me. The response shall be at the earliest. All the images courtesy is the Google Images. Contact me, civilconclave@gmail.com, or at my Telegram group, Ask Srini Telegram Groups. The link is as follows. Please kindly subscribe, like and share. which will motivate me for a further good presentation.